After an intense first week of practice, the second week of camp for the Quakers began with media day on Monday. It meant for an early start as players were lined up in the Dunning Coaches Center before 8 a.m. for individual headshots, each of them dressed to impress, at least from the waist up. Then the team headed outdoors to Franklin Field for introductory meetings with the Penn support staff, as well as the 2010 team photo. After some last-minute adjustments and pampering, the 130-plus contingent of team and staff members, through some direction, eventually settled in for the team photo. Group photos were next as players and coaches assembled by class, position, and geographic region for even more photos. Throughout the festivities, more than a dozen members of the local and national media were on hand to talk with players and coaches. Head coach Al Bagnoli spent the better part of half an hour speaking with the large contingent, and still found time between interviews to speak with the Penn Sports Network about the impact Media Day has on the program.
It's good. I think it's good for our kids. It's good to be recognized as one of the better programs in our league. You know, it's good for our kids who, work their tail off, not only out in the field, but also in the classroom, kind of get a little bit of that recognition because, you know, they're about as pure a student-athlete as you're going to find in the country. You know, so I think for a lot of reasons, it's a positive force. So it's always nice when you have a lot of people out here. It's always nice when you get covered by, you know, both the print and the TV media. So it's good for our kids, and it's certainly good for their psyche. And
Media Day was busy for freshmen and preseason All-Americans alike, including Andrew Sampson, who was asked about Penn's great tradition.
Yeah, it's one of the first things that he mentioned to us when we all met as a team on our first day last week about how, you know, we kind of take it for granted about the history that we have here as a program. I think now going into over 133rd season or something like that. So just about the history and the 800 wins, and we know about Coach Bagnoli's tenure here and about how successful he's been. And then, you know, kind of going out on top as back-to-back champions.
Hopefully Andrew's right, and we'll see this photo hanging on football's Wall of Champions next summer.